On Tuesday, April 25th, the First Customer Partner Roundtable for SAP BTP ABAP Environment will take place. This event is an opportunity for SAP customers and partners using ABAP Steampunk to share tips and tricks with each other and ask the product team questions. Participants will discuss features and highlights from the latest release and any related questions. If you're interested in attending the roundtable, check out the blog post for more information and instructions on how to register. In addition to the roundtable, SAP has also released a new version of the RAP generator. The new version comes with a new UI that lets you enter the basic project data upfront, such as the type of data source being used, the binding type, and whether the project shall be draft enabled or not. This updated version is available on GitHub. To learn more about the RAP generator and the new features of this new latest version, read the blog post. Check out the links in the description to learn more about these updates.
There's a new blog post on using VDI5 in various scenarios to help automate the testing of your SAP UI5 applications. The posts provide detailed steps on setup and configuration, making it easier for developers to implement testing in their projects. This also includes how to set up GitHub Actions so that tests run on every pull request. You can find the link to the post below. Speaking of SAP UI5, several more versions will end cloud provisioning in Q2 of 2023 and will be removed from the SAP UI5 content delivery network. If you're using one of the more recent versions, we recommend upgrading to at least version 1.108, which is the latest minor version with long-term maintenance. If you have an older version of SAP UI5, you will need to upgrade to a more current patch. To learn more about the versions reaching the end of their cloud provisioning life and which ones you should be upgrading to, check out the post linked below. Happy coding!
Remember me talking about the new analytic model, which is the go-to analytic consumption entity for SAP Datasphere? Two new posts were published by SAP experts recently, presenting calculated and restricted measures, which were not available in SAP Data Warehouse Cloud so far, and exception aggregations, which cover special reporting use cases where simple aggregations are not sufficient and more flexible query requirements need to be addressed. But it's not the only series of blog posts that SAP Datasphere experts are publishing for you. As well, every Friday, there is a new post discussing Intelligent Lookup, a product's capability to match external data with internal data that semantically fit together, even if there is no common keys between these two data sources. Three out of planned articles have been published so far. Another feature of SAP Datasphere that generates a lot of interest among customers is the new replication flow. This cloud-based data replication tool is designed to simplify data integration processes by eliminating the need for additional on-premise components. It uses the Data Intelligence Embedded Environment and DI connectors to connect to remote sources. We discussed some advanced features of SAP Datasphere so far, but if you are a beginner interested in the introduction to the product and the introduction to the SAP Data Warehouse strategy, then we got you covered with the new free learning journey Explore SAP Datasphere. Enjoy!